Hello, everybody. It's me, Carmine DiStefano, the Bookman.
They call him the Bookman. His rants never end. He's angry and he's loud and he has a lot of friends. If you have Alyssa Milano's number, you can always send it to Carmine DiStefano, the Bookman.
That song don't make no sense.
Hello, everybody. It's me, Carmine DiStefano, the Bookman. In 1984, Hollywood gave us a movie about a bunch of forgottens standing up for themselves and winning in the end. They called it The Karate Kid. So, of course, after that, they bastardized the original idea of the first movie by making two substandard sequels and an ungodly spin-off. Then in 2010, they decided to remake this movie with Jackie Chan and Will Smith and Jada Pinkett's son in the remake called The Karate Kid. How would the new one fare? Well, let's take a look at it together, shall we? Movie opens with Dre, played by Jade Smith, and his mother leaving Detroit. Might as well. And the answer is... yes, I would! Instead of moving to the West Coast, they travel overseas to China and attempt to adjust to their new life. Luckily for Dre, he meets up with an American-born blonde kid.
Dre, we are not doing this in Beijing. Dre, pick up your jacket.
This won't be a recurring theme, will it? Soon after moving in, they require maintenance and meet up with the super Mr. Han, played by Jackie Chan. I get it. Catching the fly with Chaz Dick. Yeah, go ahead. Let's see what he does. Well, I didn't expect that. Dre then goes out in the park, trying to get to know his fellow children, when he runs into Mei Ying. She wants...
coming back. May I attach you here?
I'll keep it to myself. Dre sees bullies picking on her and tries to save her like Danielson did in the original one, and as was the case in the original one, he gets his ass kicked. This movie does it rather emphatically, to the point where unless that ground is made out of rubber, this kid would be dead. In school, he runs into a dilemma, trying to hide from the bullies while getting to know Mei Ying. Unfortunately, as was the case in the first one, Dre... as was the case in the first movie, Dre tries to teach self-defense to himself when Mr. Han heeds the call for maintenance.
Dre, I don't care! Come pick it up now! God, how many times do I have to ask you?
Dre, pick up the jacket! Attempting to dispel this problem he has with the bullies, Dre finds a dojo where he can learn... what was that?
Kung Fu.
Kung Fu? What's the name of this movie again? Oh, then if it's The Karate Kid, why the fuck is he learning Kung Fu? Just like in the original, Dre sees that the training is intense, but instead of Kreese, we've got this guy. He also finds, like in the first one, his main nemesis, and knows that that's not the answer. So he complains.
Dre, please let me help you. I can't help you if you don't tell me what's wrong. Well, please.
You don't care what's wrong. All you care about is how happy I am and how great the ice cream is. Well, I'm not happy. I hate it here.
That sounds a lot like the original.
The truth.
No, you don't want to hear the truth. All you want to hear is how great it is out here. Well, it may be great for you, but it sucks for me. I hate this place. I hate it. I just want to go home. Why don't we just go back home?
Almost word for word. During a school trip, Mei Ying and Dre get cozy with one another. Afterwards, he sets up a prank on his enemies, who then track him down. When they corner him, they kick the living shit out of him. Like in the first one, when Mr. Miyagi saved Daniel, Mr. Han saves him. Please don't tell me you're gonna beat up these little kids. In the first Karate Kid, Miyagi had the hand clap treatment. This one is a little more intense. Daniel was able to convince Miyagi to talk to the sensei in his rival dojo, so Dre, of course, has to convince Mr. Han to do the same. When he meets this crazed, intense sensei, Mr. Han decides to take Dre under his wing and sets up a challenge at the upcoming tournament. While Dre's going to his first lesson, he finds a car that Mr. Han keeps repairing for seemingly no reason. In the spirit of the original, where we had wax on, wax off, paint the fence, sand the floor, all that, this one we get...
Pick up your jacket. Hand it up.
Oh, don't forget to do it with a smile on your face. This goes on for a while, through rain, sun, sleet, all that stuff. During the training, Dre's mother, Mr. Han, Mei Ying, and he attend a puppet show. Mei Ying and Dre go backstage to be alone with one another and kiss. 12-year-olds make it out. This is why teenage pregnancy is a problem in America, people. There I said it. Dre is getting a little impatient with the training until, as was the case in the first one, Mr. Han shows what he's learned through a simulated attack. He then takes Dre on an excursion across the wall of China to learn the spiritual angle of Kung Fu. There, Dre notices a woman charming a snake with body movements, which intrigues him. They continue to use these strange methods of training to amp up his skills and prepare him for the tournament. Still, Dre has time to hang with Mei Ying. Although she has an important rehearsal to go to, he convinces her to chill with him. They barely make it in time for the rehearsal. After she seems to do well, her parents convince Mei Ying to split ties with Dre. On what was supposed to be their day off, Dre finds Mr. Han, broken down, beating up the car he was fixing. Why?
I was driving. Argue about something. I was so angry. I lost control. I tried to remember. I cannot remember what we argue about.
So what you're saying is that Mr. Han killed his family and he did it by accident? Dre coaxes Mr. Han into training with him, as it is the best medicine for internal struggling. Now Dre is prepared for the tournament. But first...
Wo jiao Dre Parker. Wo de xing wei dui ning jia shi su zhong.
Things seem to go his way. Now it's tournament time. And since we saw it already in the first one, let's just go through it quick. Dre has a hard time adjusting to the new rules, but he picks it up pretty quick. He wins his first match while his rival dojo boys are beating the shit out of their opponents. Dre moves up through his bracket. We see...
Nice hair.
The only kid that has a heart in the rival dojo is told to take Dre out completely, which he does by injuring his leg. Then Dre convinces Mr. Han to do the healing trick on him. He makes it to his last match against his main nemesis. The match goes back and forth until the main nemesis really puts a hurting on Dre's leg. Then he goes through that special technique he just saw on the wall of China. Yeah, we all know where this is going. We've seen it before. He's gonna set him up for some cheesy kick in the face. Dre wins and earns respect from his previous adversaries, as well as the heart of Mei Ying. This also solidifies his friendship with Mr. Han. And that's pretty much it. So what did I think of this movie? Really, it wasn't that fantastic a remake. I mean, it's a complete copy of the first movie. Very little has changed. The setting, the characters, maybe, but it's more or less the same fucking movie. It's also really disturbing to me when you see kids performing actions that were performed originally by teenagers. I don't care so much to see teenage boys beating up a teenage boy, but 10 and 12 year olds? Little creepy. Plus, they didn't go as far in the relationship between Daniel and Ali as they did in this one, and these are fucking children! Not to mention the fact that I liked Mr. Miyagi as an unassuming sensei. Mr. Han is Jackie Chan. If your super was Jackie Chan and he wasn't fighting, you'd be like, dude, you're Jackie Chan. Fight! And I didn't like the fact that he killed his family in a car accident. Mr. Miyagi had no choice in the matter. His wife died during childbirth. That had nothing to do with him, which made him a tragic figure. Mr. Han's just a screw-up. That's all he is. And I can't emphasize the ignorance behind calling a movie The Karate Kid when he's learning Kung Fu. I think any true master of either one of these arts would be ashamed to see people considering no difference between karate and kung fu. That's like calling a Hindu the Muslim kid or vice versa. It's complete ignorance, people. There was better choreography in the fighting, but then again, these are children, and to see children performing these moves on their own is kinda out there, to say the very least. Especially since Dre is not doing simple kung fu. He seems to be doing some advanced moves. He's only 12, and he only was training for a couple of months, maybe. Also, the original one had purpose. This one seemed more like Jaden Smith saying, Daddy, Daddy, I want to be the Karate Kid. Well, I don't know, son. Come on, I'll be the Karate Kid. Okay, fine. But it didn't seem like there was any real reason behind it other than making a remake. It wasn't terrible. If it was an original movie, it actually would have been pretty decent. But since it's just a complete copy of the first movie, I really couldn't get that much into it. I mean, really, if the original one was hard to grasp, this one is complete fantasy. There's no way a kid can pick all that up in just a few weeks. But what else do you expect from Hollywood? Thank you all for watching. I have more for you soon to come. So stay tuned, take care, and have a great day. Just